Today on the CarBuyingTips.com channel, we're going to show you how you can change the battery in your Lexus key remote all by yourself. So you're probably here because you got that dreaded key battery low message on your console when you went to start your Lexus this morning. And we all forget that it creeps up on us once a year. Don't waste money going over to the dealer and paying them buku dollars to do it. It's actually quite simple, so let's get right into it. Remotes typically take a 1632 battery, which is good for you because these are one of the easiest batteries to find out there. Now, the only way to tell really for sure is to pull the old one out and just confirm and make sure you buy the same battery. Or you can also look in your owner's manual and make sure that it calls out the same battery. All right, the first step for you if you're changing the battery in your Lexus key remote is to remove this leather case if you have one. A lot of people have that. Now we have to remove the mechanical key first. So you see this little latch right here? You see how it slides over to the left like this, see? So that's what we're going to do. So with one hand, you slide it over with your fingernail and then slide the key out. This is your mechanical key. Okay, then what I like to do is see there's like a little slot that goes right around that little corner there, that feature. I like to take the mechanical key and you see this little triangular piece of metal sticking out on the corner. You stick it in here in the slot on the corner and turn it clockwise, see, and it pops up the housing. So now that your Lexus key remote housing is popped open, you just remove the top part like this, gently. Set it back down. Remember the orientation now that the printed circuit board is facing up. So you can just easily lift up the board, flip it around, and remember the orientation. See, this chip goes on top of that square rubber thing. Just remember, square to square. So there's our battery. Now what I like to do is turn the circuit board around so that this little gold spring, there's two pieces of the spring on the bottom of the battery that are facing me for better mechanical leverage. So now you can get one of these miniature flathead screwdrivers or one of the micro ones that they use on sunglasses or eyeglasses. And I stick it right here in this space where you have the most amount of space, right by this gold clip in between the clip and the battery, and just pop it up like that. Okay, now here you can see we're at about 2.8 volts. And you would think that that'd be enough because it's a 3-volt battery. But, you know, most of these types of batteries, they don't drain down to zero. They drain down about a quarter or a half of a volt. They lose all of their effectiveness. That's why when you put the new battery in, you want to make sure that your new key remote battery is registering at 3 volts or higher. Remember, when you install the new battery into your Lexus key remote, you want to make sure that you're putting the engraved, the lettering, and especially the positive side up. Always put the battery in the same way that it came out. To snap the battery down into place, make sure you slide it in against the clip. See how it pushes like a spring? And then push the battery down. You will feel the battery click. So you want to make sure the battery is completely secured under all 3 of these black clips. Now remember what we said, the printed circuit board side goes up, the square chip goes over the square pad, and everything lays right in there just perfectly. Then you take the other half of the shell, put it on top, and squeeze them together. You'll feel one part snap and then the other part snaps, and that's it. Now to inspect your Lexus key remote to make sure you snapped it back together, you should see just a perfect hairline going across the bottom where the two pieces come together. And then check around the sides, see how it should look nice and normal and perfect. There shouldn't be any separation or any gaps. Now we're going to take our mechanical key and stick it back in. And you can see that it latched nice and tight. Hey, and if you're finding this video useful so far, you know what to do, people. Click that thumbs up button down below. And if you're new here, make sure you click on that subscribe button and click the gray bell icon next to it so that YouTube will alert you every time we upload a new video because you don't want to miss any of our great videos, folks. Well, thank you so much for tuning in today, folks, and we will see all of you on the next video.